So this vapor mat is going to go around the perimeter 12 to 18 inches from this edge to the block on the foundation. And it's got this air channel. It's an inch tall and a foot wide. And then it's got this filter fabric so we can allow airflow through here. So this will go to our T-riser and then up to our radon pipe. So we're gonna go all the way around the perimeter and then we're gonna run one strip down the middle where Johnny is. And then the styrofoam will go over that and then they're gonna do the radiant heat in the floor as well here. So this is why you want to be a little deep in the corners here, so that's not holding your sparkler. So I like to do the top and bottom. And then I like to get that corner. I like to use this wide tape, the T-Rex or the Gorilla. That's probably, what is that, 2.5 inches wide?
I think it said 2.6.
So it's a lot easier to run one than two or three strips of regular duct tape, and it sticks a lot better. And we'll just get this little corner. And then you do two stakes, two of these stakes in each corner, and then every few feet, do a couple just so it stays in place. And then make sure you're no further than 18 inches away from that edge. So here's our T, and that vent mat will slide in here and then it gets a 12 inch spike to go through the center. And this will stub up through the concrete and we'll hook a 4 inch pipe up to it and then reduce to our 3 inch pipe. So we want to get this close to the wall because the furnace is going here. It'd be a lot easier to put it there, but it holds the furnace out away from the wall too far. So we're going to kind of run some strips into this strip. I'm gonna run this into this. And then that'll give me a little extra to overlap into here. And this is the spot you really wanna seal well because this is where the fan will be hooked up someday, possibly, if we activate the system. And then we'll tape up this end here as well. So that's what we've done there. Tape this, we got a chunk running into here that overlaps. And then we've got all the edges taped. I'll do the same thing on the other side. And then this will tie into our main strip that runs through here. I like to dig it down a little bit just because this, I don't want this huge hub sticking out of the concrete so much. So this is called soil gas mat. Thank you to Brent at PDS Professional Discount Supply in Colorado for sending it to us. It's some leftover from a big townhome project we did last year. And it worked out well because Johnny didn't have to order any. Brent does sell to homeowners as well. We'll put a link to his website in the description of this YouTube video. Also put a link to the standard that we're following. It's on the ARST website. They got a list of all the standards that you can look at for free. I think I'm gonna dig that down a little bit more so that we're not holding our foam up. And if we're too low, we can always throw dirt in over the top of it. So there's our finished product. Plumber's marked radon right here for me. So that'll be as out of the way as we can get for him. So we've got all the soil gas mat in going around. We ran a strip down the middle here. It goes all the way around to our riser here. And the plumber's got all the subslab plumbing done. Got our kitchen island over there. Clean out here. And all the mechanical floor drain and all that are in. I got their plumbing inspection. And now we're doing the poly. And tomorrow they'll set the styrofoam after the poly and radon inspection and run the Wurzbo, and then they're pouring concrete right after that. The poly gets overlapped. You tape the seams, and then you're supposed to seal it to the foundation wall as well.